Hey there, welcome to another episode of Gaming with Banana Jim. I've got a confession to make. I'm a huge pro wrestling fan, and I've been a fan of that glorious spandex clad acrobatic soap opera ever since I was a little kid. Now, I might not be following the current WWE programming as religiously as I used to, but I can assure you I know my DDT from my pile driver, my inverted powerbomb from my reverse chin lock. I mean, I, Banana Jim, even attempted a suplex on a pillow once. It was glorious. Now this week, I'm taking a look at Fire Pro Wrestling. Now hold on there, before you get excited, it's the Xbox Live version. Now if you're a wrestling fanatic and also a video game fan, you might have heard about Fire Pro Wrestling. It's a long-running Japanese series that started in 1989. They've had countless of titles in the last couple of years. And it's a big deal. You know, Fire Pro games are a big deal. Now sure, they weren't licensed by any of the major wrestling promotions, but they still featured the likenesses of real-life wrestlers. Obviously not with their names, but you could have had a Stone Cold Steve Austin, and you would have had a Randy Orton, or you could have had Brock Lesnar. Now obviously not with their names, but they were in there, and you could have played with them. But the real hallmark of these titles was the ability to actually edit your wrestlers. So you could have actually changed that character and given the name of Hulk Hogan or given the name of Brock Lesnar. And you could alter and change. And the ability of a Fire Pro wrestling game to actually change and alter is probably one of the most awesome parts of this game. So you could create new wrestlers. You could create whole new stables. And what's really interesting and really cool about a Fire Pro game, especially the last one, Fire Pro Wrestling Returns, which was on the PS2, it had 500 slots available for user-created wrestlers. 500! I mean, that's immense! And not to mention, the game itself, the core mode of the game came with about 350 wrestlers. Now, that is awesome. But in addition, it had a customizable AI, and boy, oh boy, was the AI good. You know, you have people who play this game. Actually, they don't play the game. They just run it as a simulation. You just have two wrestlers fighting it out, and they would do, you know, the moves that you'd kind of expect them to do. The Fire Pro games are just, they just blow your mind. Now, come to think of it, I'm actually seriously considering doing a review of Fire Pro Wrestling Returns. Hopefully not in the too distant future, but it's definitely now in the back of my mind. But for now, let's return to the Xbox version of Fire Pro Wrestling. Now, I'll admit, when I saw the title of Fire Pro Wrestling, my brain went to jelly and I just instantly bought it. Because I had an expectation of what a Fire Pro Wrestling game would be all about. Instead, I have buyer's remorse. In a nutshell, this title is less of a Fire Pro Wrestling game and more of an Xbox Live Avatar Wrestling game. Now, before you accuse me of hating Xbox avatars, I actually don't have a problem with them. I actually enjoy the little bastards. Mine is wearing a banana suit, and you know, I've said too much on that. But I like the fact that you have that. It kind of personalizes your Xbox, so I don't have a problem with them. Now, the Fire Pro Wrestling game actually comes with a decent number of modes. There's the standard exhibition mode. You have a meaty campaign mode. It comes with three different difficulties, all the way from casual to underground. That's the highest. There's even a multiplayer mode. You can battle it out with similarly minded folk online and, you know, tell them what The Rock is cooking. Now, as I've said, the cutesy avatars don't bother me. I really don't mind them that much. The game itself comes with a healthy set of unlockable customizables, so you can customize your avatar to your heart's content. You can create a decent looking Lucha Libre, or you can even do a classic Western wrestler. But to be honest, it actually misses the point of the original Fire Pro games, because that was all about creativity and really going to town with what you want. You want to create a fire, like maybe Stone Cold Steve Austin, or even a new wrestler, and then, you know, take on Stone Cold. But the real problem really is that, unlike the old classics, the AI leaves much to be desired with. It's just not that good. The AI is, for lack of a better word, incredibly stupid. It's not that difficult to actually change to battle them. I took on a level 22 with a level 1 and I beat them fairly easily. Now the gameplay is exactly what you'd expect from a title that throws in your Xbox avatars. It's bare bones basics. It really doesn't take much to take down your opponents. You just have to tap the face buttons, go for a grapple, maybe use a charged up attack. Now the counter mechanic is actually something I kind of thought was fairly well done. It's a little different. To counter an opponent, you have to press the same face button as them during a grapple. So for instance, if they grapple you and they want to go for a suplex, they press X. You also press X. You'll grapple them, you'll counter them. But essentially, it boils down to 20 to a 25% chance of countering, and with those odds, you know, it's not a game that's going to keep you up at night. Since this is a wrestling title, you can perform high-risk moves from the top turnbuckle. You can taunt them. You can go for a really high-risk move, or you can just sit there for a little bit and wait for them to beat you up. Or alternatively, you can even unleash a finisher of nosebleed proportions. Now, I have to admit, some of the finishers in this game is actually pretty awesome. Yeah, they really brought a smile to my face. I mean, just take a look at this one. After every match, you earn a little bit of money and some XP that can unlock a level, or you can get a few more moves that have been unlocked. But the key really for this game is, now there's some sort of progression, but essentially the key is to win and then to upgrade your character and get some more powerful moves, like the good God, like the tickle tackle. Yeah, I don't know. But in any case, you can do that. You can upgrade your character and give him some new moves. But in conclusion, Fire Pro Wrestling is a strange game. On the one hand, you have a title that's kind of intended to draw in the hardcore Fire Pro fans, you know, the guys who grew up with Fire Pro, who know what Fire Pro is about. But then you have the gameplay that actually doesn't match the legacy. So I can't help but wonder whether this Fire Pro is just a bit of bait and switch for the hardcore fans. Because the casuals, you know, casual gamers already have simplistic wrestling titles out there. So for this to happen to Fire Pro Wrestling is a shame. It's quite terrible. So what's my final verdict? It's bad. It's a botched move.